Okay, so we're gonna do Travis picking session here, and it'll be with the to the tune of Dust in the Wind. So I guess the first thing to do, we're gonna get to Dust in the Wind. So what we're gonna do is look at our thumb being on the fifth string. And our middle finger is going to be on the second string. Okay, so those are the only strings that we're going to engage with this finger picking. So if we took the sixth string off and the first string off, it wouldn't make a difference. Except it might feel a little weird. But that said, we're not using those strings for this. And we're just going to do open, so you can leave your left hand off altogether. So the first thing we're going to do is just kind of get familiar with the string. So the thumb is going to play the fifth string, and then the middle finger is going to play the second string. Okay, so just do that again. Play the thumb on the fifth string, and then the middle finger on the second string. Okay, and do it again. And the key here that we're kind of learning is to get them back to where they're going. So thumb, middle finger. Okay, so now the next part is the thumb is going to move to the D string or the fourth string. And then the index finger is going to be on the third string, and it's always going to be there. So those ones are right beside each other, right? The fourth string with the thumb, and then the index finger on the third string, right under it. In other words, D string, and then the G string. Okay, so now let's play the first part of that again and just feel them. They're kind of like they're just on there, right? So your thumb is going to be back on the fifth string, and then we'll play it. And then you play the second string with your middle finger. And then play the fourth string, the string under it with your thumb. And then the third string with your index finger. So this is the pattern. There's nothing going on with this hand at all. So I'm going to play it a couple times. I'm going to play fifth string, second string, fourth string, third string. Five, thumb, middle, thumb, index. Thumb, middle, So now we can kind of take a moment and realize that the middle finger is always on the second string, or the second finger is always on the second string, you can say. And the index finger is always on the third string. And the thumb is just alternating from string to string, from the fifth string to the fourth string, right? So now I'm just going to go back to it. So just try to play along with that. I'm going to keep it not super slow, but it is slow. It's challenging at any tempo when you're first getting the coordination. So I'm going to keep it at a reasonable one. So I'll go thumb, middle, thumb, index, thumb. Now you can kind of see that from five to two, I'm going to call that outside. And I'm going to call these ones inside. And that's going to be important as we move on to the Travis picking. So the inside strings, out, side, in, side, out. This is the practice, right? You gotta develop this coordination to get to the next level. And it's gotta be easy. So we got five, two, four. can make it interesting too, you can say A, B, D, G, A, B, D, G. It's got to kind of get in, it's got to be almost subconscious after a while, right? It's going to double in speed. So part of practicing it slow for a while is just to learn the coordination. But now we're going to add this. So listen what is happening now. The fingers are in exactly the same spots, but the first move is to pinch with the thumb and the middle finger. So we go pinch, inside, outside, inside, pinch, inside, outside. Inside, inside, pinch, inside, outside, inside. So you pinch the 5 and 2, and then you play 4, 3, 5, 2, 4, 3. Pinch, 4, 3, 5, 2, 4, 3. So how many patterns is that in total? Two full patterns. The only difference now is instead of going like this the whole time, we go pinch, one and two and three and four and one. Even slower now for just a sec. Pinch, inside, outside, inside. Pinch, inside, outside, inside. Pinch, inside, outside, inside. Pinch, inside, outside, inside. Pinch. And we'll just stay there for a second. That's a lot of information. David, how you feeling?
Well, good, because I've been practicing that a lot.
Okay.
But I think it's important to emphasize that the pinch is the start of the chord and not the end. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Sure. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Right, of the two patterns, when we start doing the pinch, that is the first, yes.
That's the first.
That's what starts it off. Frank, is that how you finding that? Does that make, yeah, thumbs up? Okay, did I start that? I mean, I don't even have to ask. I hope that's making sense. Now I want to do it over a C chord. So if we do a C chord, there's only two chords for the intro for Dust in the Wind. Let me play it for a second. Intro is what we're kind of concerned with, and that, Yeah, that's good to play it because I remember even more about it. So the next step, let's just play a C chord. I'm going to even leave off. No, I'm not. I'm going to just stick with that because we're learning Travis picking, and there's various different alternations to it. Alterations, alternations. Is that a thing? Yeah, I guess it is. Over the C. So we're going to go pinch, inside, outside, inside. Pinch, inside, outside, inside. See how I'm counting it in eighth notes. One, two, and three, and four, and. So it's like down, and two, and three, and four, and. And I can leave the and of four off. For example, one, two, and three, and four. One, two, and three. So I'm just not doing the last and with the finger, with the index finger. So all the one, two, three, four are all with the thumb. So it's like this. One, two, three, four. This is happening this, or sorry, one, two, three, four. This happens the whole time. Let's just take a moment and just do that. Go fifth string, fourth string. Fifth string, fourth, five, four, five. And the magic is when you syncopate it. Like just keep doing the thumb. So if I leave the fingers out, it's back to just this, right? Let's do it over an A minor chord. So you can either go one, two, and three, and four, and one, two, and three, and four, and, or you could go one, two, and three, and four, one, two, and three, and four. Or you could go one, and two, and three, and four, and, which is how we started all this. So why don't we do an A minor chord? And let's go back to one and two and three and four and. So that means no pinch, right? We're just going inside, out, or sorry, outside, inside, outside, inside, five, two. Just the thumb. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. So that's a pretty thorough dissemination and kind of putting it back together.
Just out of interest, Aaron, what are the two notes, two chords?
The two chords that we're doing? Well, we're doing, you mean
No, but you
the
said there's
main
only two
notes?
chords in Dust in the Wind.
C and A minor for the intro.
Oh, right, okay.
Right, but then we're going to color them up with something else. So that's a pretty, I think that's a good little start. I don't know if you want to go farther than that or if we should just kind of pause it right there. What do you think? I mean, I can add more to it, or if we can practice just those. How, if people are feeling good about that kind of pinch inside, outside, inside, then I can add more to it right now or just kind of stop right there. I'm easy. What do you think, Frank? More? Less?
I'll go with the group. If everybody else wants to, I'd like to.
To keep going for a bit?
Yeah, just for a bit, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, let's do a little bit more. Okay. Okay, so here's the next part of that we need to kind of. We've got the finger picking going on. We've broken it down to the thumb is doing the beats, like one, two, three, four. The fingers are giving it the syncopation. That's the word for adding that kind of motion to it. And we know there's a C major chord and an A minor chord. So then what happens is we color up those chords with a melody line. So this is what the melody line sounds like. It sounds like this. This note, now I'm going to talk about individual notes, not chords. So the index finger on the first fret of the second string, just play it. And play it with your middle finger because it's always going to be played with that finger, right? We're going to stick to a really consistent kind of parameters when we're initially learning the finger picking because then you develop the muscle memory and that's kind of paramount. So index finger on the first fret of the second string and just play it. And then the next note is open B. The next note with your pinky on the third fret is a D. And then the index finger back to where it started is a C. And it's going to go to the next note, which is open B. Next is D with the pinky. It's got to be the pinky too. This is an index on the first fret. And then I'm going to just name the notes. So it's B goes back to D, three, four, C, two, three, four, B, two, three, four, D. That always goes back to C, which goes to B, which goes to D, which goes to C. And that was the full progression. And then what you're going to do, what we're going to do, is add that motion over top of the chords. So, for example, just play. Now you can just strum a C chord for a second. But try to just strum those five strings just for the sake of, like, leave these out and for accuracy. So you can start with your thumb on the fifth string. Oops, and let it stop when it gets to the first string. So it's gonna go one, two, three, and remember the next note's a B, so you gotta take your index finger off. And the next note's a D, so you gotta put your pinky on the third fret. And then you put your finger back on the C. And when you've done a full pattern, then we switch to the A minor chord, but the next note is gonna be the B. So now play an A minor chord without your index finger. Next note from B is D. Then after D is C. It's always the same direction. And we started on this note. So now we go back to the C chord, and the next note is going to be the pinky, the D. So we play. And C follows D. And B follows C. Follows B. And this is where we started. So now we go to the A minor chord, but the melody note is a C. B. that's the end of the intro. It's kind of come full cycle, right? So the melody notes have come full cycle and the chords have come full cycle. So it's interesting because it's one of those things where, like, mathematically, there's four beats per bar, there's three notes in the melody. So every 12 beats, it's going to come back to square one again, right? Because that's the common denominator. Dig it?
You were saying, or you were making a shape for an A minor, but at the same time you said C.
I don't want to confuse that with, if I said we're making the chords for the C major and the A minor shapes, and then we're adding the melody on top. I'm not going to call them different kinds of chords because that's just confuses the issue. So what we're doing is we're doing counterpoint. We're playing a C chord and an A minor chord. When we play the C chord, we play the melody C. This is the shape. This is the harmony, the chord. And then the melody on top, the counterpoint is a C. It's two different things. There's the chord C and there's the actual note C. So we're playing, does that make sense? Is that clear? So, or we could say we're playing the one chord and the six chord. The C is the one chord, the A minor is the six chord. So over top of the one chord, let's do it again. So the melody note over the one chord is a C. Then the melody goes to B. And then the melody goes to D. And then the melody goes back to C, which is where we started. So then we go to the six chord, AKA the A minor. And we know the melody is always moving. So now the melody is B, which goes to D, which goes back to C, which goes back to B. And that was a full cycle. That was four melody notes. And now we go back to the C chord with D in the melody. The one chord with D. C is the melody. B is the melody. And this is where we started with the D. So once we've come full circle, we go to the next chord, the sixth chord, with the melody note being C. B is the melody note. D is the melody note. And now we're right back where we started, with C being the melody note over the C, over the sixth chord. Wow.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So then the next thing we do after that is just add the Travis picking. But let's just do the Travis picking with open strings again. Let's just give all that a break. So remember, the middle finger is always on two, the index finger is always on three, and the thumb is alternating on beats 1, 2, 3, 4 from the fifth string to the fourth string. So let's 1, 2, 3, pinch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, and 3, and 4. Okay. Because we've done all the parts, hopefully thoroughly enough that we can kind of rewind or just get the concept and then practice it if you want to go through this as a video later. So now I'm going to put it all together. And I would, if you can do it right off the bat, then wow. If I can do it right off the bat, wow. So let's give it a whirl. I'm going to try to keep a reasonable tempo. So it's going to be 1 and 2. And starts on C and D back to the C, which indicates the chain with the open B. So we changed to C with the D. That's where we started. So now we're on the A minor, straight up. pattern. Let's do one more. People seemed engaged. One, two, from the sea. Okay.
Aaron, could you just briefly recap the sequence of notes? So from C, is it D next?
No. It goes C, B, D.
Oh, C, B, D.
And then the whole pattern, it goes C, B, D, C, B, D, C, B, D, C, B, D. You know, that many times, basically, over the 12 bars.
And then it's A minor.
Cannaboid, it's CBD, it's all the rage. Right? CBD.
CBB.
I don't know what CBD. It's now, I don't know what it stands for. Something to do with weed, right? Cannaboid something, I don't know. They give it to dogs. People take it to go to sleep. I don't know.
And the A minor.
Dust in the wind, CBD.
And the A minor?
It's no, it don't, that's, that has nothing to do with it. It changes constantly over each chord. So you do one pattern over each chord, and the melody comes around after 12 bars. That's what makes it so syncopated and interesting, because it changes every time. It's not over one or the other. It starts at a different point every time you go around the cycle, because there's only three notes in a melody, but there's four beats in each bar. So the common denominator is 12. So it starts on a C, and it never gets back to where it started until you've gone through the entire cycle. Does that make sense? So every time you go through one pattern, it changes to the next chord, but it starts on a different melody note each time until the common denominator gets to back in place, and then it gets into the actual song. Does that make sense? And I'm sorry I was kind of abrupt there. I just don't want to confuse the issue by letting you think that it's the same, it's a specific thing over each chord. So it's really important to know that it's different every time. Let me do it one more time just to catch that. So here, let's do it one more time. Because it changes. Like the first time it starts on a C, then it starts on a B, then it starts on a D, then it starts on a C, and then you change chords because you've done it that many beats. So one more time. Here we go. So one, two, ready to pinch, and bars. So then we change, but the melody note changes also. Now we're back to where we started with the melody note. So the next chord is C with C as our first note of the bar, so we know this is the last bar because this is where we started. little change to into the next part of the song. And it's one of those patterns that if you just, well, once you get it, it's kind of like one of the, it's like riding a unicycle. It's as easy as that. Has anybody tried to ride a unicycle? It's impossible to ride a unicycle. It's nothing like riding a unicycle. This is way easier. But once you get the flow of it, it's a really meditative thing, which is what makes it such a great song. And just to have those two numbers kind of superimposed and kind of going around, creating that syncopation is very satisfying. So there we have it. Let's just leave it at that for practicing. Okay, we'll try it again here just for the sake of our progress with this song. So from the intro. Work in progress. There's a little model that you can kind of work with.